Hi, welcome back to our series of videos on migraine and science. Today, a longer episode than usual and maybe the most important one of the series, as we will see how to identify migraine risk factor sensitivities, and as a consequence, how to get control of a migraine. Let's start with a few reminders. First, risk factors pile up. Risk exposure changes over time, and if it reaches the migraine threshold, symptoms appear. At risk factor level, risk is the quantity we're exposed to times our sensitivity, and sensitivity can be low, medium, or high. There are three ways of staying below the migraine threshold: avoid risk, mitigate risk, and raise the threshold. Talk to your doctor about migraine preventive medication to raise the threshold. Act on avoidance and mitigation strategies. So, how can we be most impactful on risk factors? Well, first of all, we need to identify potential risk factors, and for this, I recommend that you use a migraine tracking app, as it will suggest a number of the most reported risk factors among its users. Spoiler, they will call them triggers. With a 3 million user community, MigraineBuddy is the global reference of migraine tracking apps. So let's see the most common reported risk factors in the app. Anxiety and stress, sleep disruption, weather, hormones, food, dehydration, neck pain, skipped meals, sinus and allergies, medication, exertion, smells, loud noises, and skipped medication or complements. If you want to go to the bottom of food and lifestyle risk factors, the Good Days program is for you. It covers 20 plus migraine food chemicals and a number of lifestyle risk factors. You will find all the links in the description under the video. Measure your sensitivity to risk factors. Unfortunately, the risk meter we've talked about in previous videos does not exist. There is currently no way to directly measure your sensitivity to most risk factors. We can only do this by comparison. And there are four ways to do that, spanning from do nothing to control everything. If do nothing worked, we would not be here today, so I exclude this one. Control everything means that we minimize our exposure to every and any risk factor at all time. It's a kind of brutal force. And it's useless for risk factor to which we have low sensitivity, and also it's quite difficult to cope with over time. Then we have the easy way that does not work, the soft test, also known as soft elimination. The idea behind it is, I don't have symptoms, I get exposed to a risk factor on purpose, and then if I have symptoms, I am sensitive, and if I don't, I'm not sensitive. If this sounds intuitively logical to you, let's see why you should be cautious about your intuitions. And don't get me wrong here, I'm not finger pointing anyone. I was once myself convinced that this was the best and only working solution. First of all, as I cannot measure my level of risk, I am only sure of one thing. If I don't have symptoms, I am below the migraine threshold. I don't know whether my risk level is very close or very far from the threshold or somewhere in between, but it is below the threshold for sure. Let's test our assumption on two extreme cases. Case A, I'm very close to the threshold before testing. And case B, I am very far from the threshold before testing. So, case A, my risk level was close to the threshold before testing. On this graph, I'm exposed to hormones, weather changes, stress, and added sugar-related risks. Then I have tannins-rich food. My risk level was so close to the threshold before having tannins that I will quickly have symptoms regardless of my sensitivity to tannins. Low, medium, or high. As a consequence, I cannot conclude on how sensitive I am. Now case B, my risk level is far from the threshold before testing. Then I have food with tannins. If I have low or medium sensitivity to tannins, I will not get symptoms. And if I have high sensitivity to tannins, I will get symptoms. And that should not be a surprise to anyone at this stage. As a consequence, if I don't have symptoms, I cannot conclude whether I have low or medium sensitivity. But I'm sure that I'm not highly sensitive to tannins. And if I have symptoms, I cannot conclude either, because of case A outcome. if I had a way to detect that I'm in case B instead of case A, then I would conclude that I have high sensitivity to tannins. But remember, the only thing I know for sure before testing is that I am below the migraine threshold. But I cannot figure out whether my risk level was close to the threshold or far from it. Soft testing only helps me discarding high sensitivity in case I don't have symptoms soon after testing. Not so helpful in the end, and quite different from what seemed to be a logical outcome. The only remaining solution is a thorough test plan. It is the one we use in the Good Days program. It's a two-step plan. First, you need to minimize your exposure to as many risk factors as possible, so that you stay well clear of the threshold. In this example, I mitigate my sleep disruption, I mitigate stress, and I make sure it's not that time of the month for hormones, and that the weather is fair before testing. And only then do I have tannins. If I have symptoms shortly after having tannins, then I'm probably highly sensitive. If symptoms appear after repeated exposure, I'm probably medium sensitive. And if I still have no symptoms after repeated exposure, then good news, I definitely have low sensitivity. I cannot be 100% sure about medium or high sensitivity, because other sources of migraine risk can interfere. I recommend to test again at a later stage and confirm or discard high or medium sensitivity. Once you've identified how sensitive you are to a migraine risk factor like tannins, it is time to act. If you're highly sensitive, avoid risk exposure. Do not have any food containing tannins, such as tea, coffee, berries, other red fruits, chocolate. Substitute them with tannins-free food, such as ginger water or yellow fruits. If you have medium sensitivity, mitigate your exposure. Minimize your intake of food with tannins and substitute them with tannins-free food as much as you can. If you have low sensitivity, do not bother about this risk factor and focus on others. No restriction on food containing tannins. But be careful about untested food chemicals though. Red wine contains alcohol, tea contains caffeine, and berries contain histamine, and so on. Quiz of the day. Which of the following risk factors can you not or hardly control? Food-related, answer A. Weather-related, answer B. Hormones-related, answer C. And sleep disruption-related, answer D. The correct answers are B, weather risk, and C, hormones risk. Sleep disruption risk can be mitigated with lifestyle-specific adjustments. And food-related risk can be avoided or mitigated as well, following a migraine-specific program, such as the Good Days program. Weather-related risks are way more difficult to control or mitigate. To a certain extent, you can avoid bright light by wearing sunglasses, but it may not be convenient when you're indoors. You can also control the levels of humidity and temperature as long as you stay indoors. But it is way more difficult, if at all possible, to control atmospheric pressure variations. Menstrual cycles-related risks are also very difficult to control, because they're linked to the levels of hormones, such as estrogen and progesterone, that can dramatically fluctuate over the cycle. How can you test your sensitivity despite hormones-related risks? If you use a migraine tracking app such as Migraine Buddy, you can track your menstrual cycles as well. First, analyze your last few cycles to find out which days are usually impacted. Then, avoid false positives these days. The best solution is to avoid testing, but if you tested and had symptoms, you cannot conclude, as hormones-related risks may have interfered. How to test despite weather risk? First, identify how weather impacts you and when. If you use Migraine Buddy, the monthly weather reports provides you information on your weather sensitivity. Second, use your tracking app's weather forecast tools to avoid testing on risky days and discard tests that ended up with symptoms on such days. Takeaways. Soft test, also known as soft elimination, is fast and simple. Unfortunately, it's not efficient beyond discarding some high sensitivities. Identifying sensitivities takes time, so do take your time. Control all controllable risk factors first, then test. If no symptoms after 5 or more days of testing, low sensitivity. If symptoms appear after a few days of testing, potential medium sensitivity. If symptoms appear within 1 day of testing, potential high sensitivity. In both cases, test again at a later stage to confirm. Do not conclude on tests with symptoms if you suspect interference with hormones or weather-related risks. Test again at a later stage and discard these ones. See you next time.